The offense that started it all, driving while being a woman, made Loujain Alhathloul famous and drew the ire of the Saudi government. Now sentenced to nearly 6 years in prison after a trial in a special terrorism court on charges including agitating for change and using the internet to harm public order.
She's very strong. She has a very strong character.
Alia Alhathloul believes her sister will not stop speaking out and is demanding action on claims she was tortured in custody.
She wants to make sure that there is a real investigation and not just a cover-up investigation, a real investigation about the torture, because this is something that hurts her so much.
The conviction comes even after Saudi Arabia lifted the law banning women from driving more than 2 years ago. The United Nations and civil rights groups have loudly criticized the country for widespread human rights violations.
It's not just women's rights activists. It's academics, it is journalists, it is all forms of activists advocating on a range of issues are being silenced.
Global Affairs Canada said the conviction and sentence are deeply troubling, and we understand that early release is possible and advocate for it. The Saudi court suggested Alhathloul could be released within months after spending more than 2 years in jail awaiting trial. Alhathloul studied for 4 years at the University of British Columbia. Friends here are worried, but inspired.
She has never compromised her integrity. She has never compromised her morals. She has always courageously stood for what's right, even when she's faced grave consequences as a result.
Some analysts suggest a possible early release is an attempt by the Saudis to distance themselves from this high-profile case as the Biden administration arrives with its promise of action on human rights. Greg Rasmussen, CBC News, Vancouver.